Hi.
So today I'll be finally uploading my first video for painting. I think a lot of you have been asking me for this one. So I'll start off with a really simple pair of earrings. Now, like you've seen, all that I have done is, this is a fired piece, by the way. This is a properly fired piece, this one. And I have just painted a coat of black acrylic paint on this one. I'll show you, you know, how this is done. I have some diluted paint, and I think one of the most comfortable brands that I have been with using on terracotta is probably Fevicryl acrylic. Fevicryl acrylic, especially the hobby idea colors. I think they turn out pretty well, and they give an even coat and finish. So I think you know, that's probably the way to go. I would not recommend the soft colors. You know, just, I think there's a difference now. There are paints you get with fluorescent color caps. I would not really recommend that. I would recommend the ones with the white cap on. So we'll start. I'm just using a normal, you can use for base coat, you know, you can choose to use either a flat brush or even a round tip brush, and that's totally up to you. I'm just using a flat brush over here, and paint, which is black paint, which is relatively diluted. Now, because terracotta is well fired, there's generally a good, it absorbs really well and really quickly. So you'll see that, you know, the paint kind of dries, you know, very soon, just a couple of seconds, and it dries up. I'm painting the entire thing. You may want to give it a couple of seconds for it to just dry completely before doing the back. If you see, you can see that it's almost drying, and dries without leaving any kind of paint brush marks and things like that. I think a lot of you do ask me about that, and I think one of the main reasons is when you don't dilute your paint well. You know, it's I very rarely do straight from the bottle to the piece. I always add a little bit of water, you know, before putting on you know, a coat like this of paint, especially when it's to cover such a large area. So you know, so if you see that the paint is almost like 90% dry, I go back and I just cover the coat of paint. And it's done. You see that it's almost, you know, it's drying like in a jiffy. It's pretty quick. You know, it's dried. This is just paint from my, you know, from the brush and stuff like that. So it's already dried here. And we keep it down. So we have these two pieces. Now, ideally, you know, I want to color these, or rather paint these, in a shade of black, gold, and red. You know, currently let's stick to a combination like that. Now, this technique, what I'll be showing you now, I won't make use of a brush for something like for the next technique. What I'm going to show you, I'm directly going to be using my index finger and my thumb in order to do the next coat of a gold paint on this. For that, the paint is not diluted. For that, if you see, this is just normal acrylic gold paint, and this is not diluted. This is directly, you know, just the way it is. No water has been mixed in this. And for this technique, you don't want water to be mixed. Make sure that you take this quantity of paint, a little quantity of paint in your index finger, and rub it well between, you know, your two fingers like this. Because the idea is you will be dabbing paint along this manner on the piece. So when there is too much of a quantity of paint on a single finger, that may end up seeping through the work, which you don't want. Once you're convinced that there is an even coat of paint, you can start doing it. If you feel that the coat is starting to get light, or you know, if you're not this thing, keep repeating the process. Take a little more paint, always make sure you're rubbing and dab. You can be fast with this, you know. It's a really quick and an easy way to get a lot of surface area covered in this method. Gives you a very even matte kind of a finish. I'm just going on to repeating the coat a couple of times, just so that I get it nice and even. There you go. You have a nice even coat of paint that's on. We start with this one. Always make sure your black is completely dry, because you don't want colors to just, you know, mix and form something else. Because obviously when you mix a shade of gold and black, you end up getting antique gold or antique black, whichever is more. I'm repeatedly, you know, dipping paint, rubbing. Please remember to rub the paint like this, so that there's an even coat spread on your hand, and only dab, don't rub this way. Please dab, dab. It's an easy work to be done on something which has a lot of work, such as this, for example. You know, you can get the corners. Yeah, your hands get a little messy, no doubt about it, but I think it's worth the effort. You have two evenly painted ones. You may want to just, you know, clean your hands after this, because the paint tends to, you know, obviously dry on your you know, on your fingers. But once you, if you wipe it off immediately, and it just clears up like in no time. Now the next thing what we'll do is, like I said, I wanted it to be black, gold and red. We have black in, we have gold in, and if you see, the sides are absolutely clean. This I would suggest would, you know, the more you do, the more practice you would receive, the more practice you would get rather. So, you know, you would always want to finish off the sides and make sure the paint doesn't kind of, you know, slip on the sides and all that. If it does, please use a little bit of black paint and touch up. You know, because I think this really matters when you're trying to finish off a product really nice and beautifully. We use red. Now again, I go back to diluting a little bit of red. See, the dilution honestly depends on how thick or how thin your paint from the bottle really is. So there is no specific proportion that I would give you, or I can give you, because that's something that you may have to judge on your own. But you don't want the paint to be way too runny, or you don't want the paint to be very thick. There you go. I have a little bit of red on. This is like a 00 synthetic brush that I have here. It's a thin brush, and now I can start working on the design part of it. I'm just going to do a little bit of highlights, probably leave the center, you know, maybe once I do these sides, I can decide if I want something else in the center or not. So there we go. Be neat with this, be gentle, be slow. If you feel the tip of your brush is not holding enough paint, please keep dipping paint. You have something like this. I'll do the other one now. There you go. You have two of these. Obviously, the red one is not dried yet, the red paint. You know, you can obviously choose to put, I think, you know, I'll probably paint it red in the center as well. And there. Ta-da! It's done. So, you know, obviously, quite obviously, the paint is quite wet in the, you know, in the center. And that is because I have put a slightly thicker coat, I would say, you know, in the center, because obviously there is a coat of black at the base. Then on top of that, there is a coat of gold on top of it, and then comes the red. So, you know, the top coat, let it be a little bit more prominent. It helps the color, you know, each of the colors show up really well in this. And that's really important, because if your coat is too light, that wouldn't really look very nice. It wouldn't give the product a completely finished look. This one is totally done, and you know, this is, I think these are really, I mean, these are bright and pretty festive earrings. That's over here. Obviously, these are hook earrings, which is why you see the hook part over here. And you know, I'll start showing assembling videos you know, pretty soon. So yeah, this is it. And this should dry in like a couple of more minutes. I think the red on the outside is almost starting to dry, but the one in the center will obviously take some time to dry. So I really hope you, you know, you found this video useful. I think a lot of you have been asking me for painting videos, and, you know, I certainly will continue to upload more. You know, if you found this video useful, if you liked it, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and thank you so much for watching. Pretty, isn't it? It's like how they looked like this, how they looked and how they are.